Good evening. You're watching NDTV. I'm Sarah Jacob. The big story at this hour. The farmers protesting against the centre's farm laws have received permission from the Delhi police to hold their tractor rally on Republic Day. And protesting farmers will be allowed to enter Delhi, but they can't disturb the Republic Day parade, the Delhi police said this evening, declaring that this tractor rally will begin after the day's traditional big parade that takes place at the Rajpath, which terminates at the iconic Red Fort. The farmers, who've been sitting on protests outside the borders of Delhi for nearly 2 months now, will have to enter Delhi to access the ring road. And the green signal came after two rounds of meetings between the police and the farmers. One was with the farmers who have promised a peaceful rally that will move along a road that encircles the city, known here as the Ring Road. The police have said that the permission was given to show respect to the farmers' demands, even as they claim that 300 park Twitter handles have been created to disrupt the farmers' rally scheduled for Republic Day.
जो फार्मर्स का संयुक्त किसान मोर्चा का उनकी जो इच्छा ट्रैक्टर रैली के रूप में दिल्ली में आकर उसे निकालने की थी, उसको रेस्पेक्ट करते हुए दिल्ली के तीन जगहों से सीधे जो बैरिकेड्स और जो सिक्योरिटी अरेंजमेंट जो हमारा लगा है वहां से उसे हटाकर उनको दिल्ली के अंदर उन मेन रोड्स पे कुछ किलोमीटर तक अंदर आए, करीब 63 से 64 किलोमीटर का स्ट्रेच टिकरी बॉर्डर से एंटर करने पर और वही करीब 62-63 किलोमीटर का स्ट्रेच जब हम सिंघू बॉर्डर से एंटर करते हैं तब, और गाजीपुर से जब एंटर करते हैं तो तकरीबन 46 किलोमीटर का जो स्ट्रेच जो टोटल साइकिल है, ट्रैक्टर रैली को डिस्टर्ब करने के बहुत सारे इनपुट्स इंटेलिजेंस के थ्रू और वेरियस एजेंसीज के थ्रू ये बार बार आ रहे हैं। एक नमूने के तौर पर, एक एग्जाम्पल के तौर पर अगर बताएं तो 13 जनवरी से 18 जनवरी का इस 7 दिन के एनालिसिस में इसमें जितने जो लोग इससे जुड़े हुए हैं उनके मन में एक भ्रम पैदा करने के लिए 308 ट्विटर हैंडल पाकिस्तान से जनरेट हुए हैं।
आज बिल्कुल एक छोटी मीटिंग थी सिर्फ दिल्ली पुलिस के ऑफिसर्स के साथ, क्योंकि कल जो हमारा सारा एग्रीमेंट हो चुका था उसके बाद रात को सिग्नेचर्स हुए हैं और पुलिस की तरफ से फॉर्मल परमिशन मिल गई है, तो उन्होंने फॉर्मल परमिशन के लिए बुलाया था और जो कल से जो भी छोटे मोटे इश्यूज आए हैं वो सब इश्यूज को सॉर्ट आउट करने के लिए बुलाया था। तो जैसा मैंने कल कहा था, 26 जनवरी को परेड होगी, हम दिल्ली के अंदर जाएंगे और शांतिपूर्ण तरीके से परेड होगी। बस कुछ छोटे मोटे इश्यूज थे, वो सब सॉर्ट आउट हो गए हैं।
Farm unions have been talking about holding Kisan Gantantra Parade on 26th of January, and finally a nod has come from Delhi police with some do's and don'ts. Farm unions have been adamant on holding this rally. Supreme Court had said it's a matter of law and order and it is for Delhi police, or it's for police to decide on this matter. There have been multiple rounds of talk with Haryana, UP and Delhi police also of the farm unions to discuss the matter. Finally, after two crucial meetings between Delhi police and farm unions, Delhi police has given a nod to these farm unions to hold their tractor rally. Now, there is the crucial Republic Day parade of the nation happening. Delhi police has said the tractor rally or tractor parade can happen only after that, which will be around after 11:30 a.m. Then the number of tractors also coming into the national capital will also be decided and discussed between farm unions and the Delhi police. Again, a very crucial revelation which Delhi police has done in the press conference is that there are reports of this tractor rally to be disrupted. They also talked about 308 Pakistan Twitter accounts which were attempting to disrupt the tractor parade. So that is one crucial information that Delhi police gave, and they said security will be provided to the tractor parade, and overall a 100 kilometer route within Delhi is decided for farmers to hold the Kisan Gantantra parade. With camera person Pawan Kumar, Arun Singh for NDTV.
So a large convoy of tractors moving towards Delhi. Right now I am at the
पानीपत नियर पानीपत टोल प्लाजा एंड एक्चुअली हाफ ए किलोमीटर अवे फ्रॉम पानीपत टोल प्लाजा एंड व्हाट यू कैन सी हियर दैट ट्रैक्टर्स कमिंग इन फ्रॉम पंजाब एंड हरियाणा दे आर ऑल मूविंग टुवर्ड्स दिल्ली टुवर्ड्स द सिंगू बॉर्डर विच फॉल्स ऑन दिस रूट Actually, the farmers have given this call for tractor parade on Republic Day, and the call was also given that people should start reaching here by 24th of January. That is why a large contingent of farmers with their tractors and trolleys are coming in from far-flung districts like Amritsar, Gurdaspur, Tarntaran, Pathankot, and they're all moving towards Delhi. And that is why on the Panipat Highway, near the Panipat Toll Plaza Highway, there is a traffic snarl, and you can see behind me that tractor, trolleys, they're all stuck here. They're moving slowly. And for the last half an hour, we have seen people getting stuck here, traffic moving slowly. And they're all reaching towards Singhu border to participate in this tractor parade, which is going to be one of the biggest in the history of farm agitation. People from all walks of life and all age group are participating in this farm agitation from both the states of Punjab and Haryana. In Panipat, Mohammed Ghazali for NDTV.
And Narun also spoke earlier with students and artists who are making a tableau for the Republic Day tractor parade.
We're coming to you from Tikri border. Behind me is Trolley Talkies. We are very close to Republic Day, a crucial day for our nation. Ye kya cheez hai? Aap concept bataiye, Trolley Talkies kya hai?
सो ट्रॉली टॉकीज एक कलेक्टिव इनिशिएटिव है जिसमें हमने सोचा कि यहाँ पे जो किसान या प्रोटेस्टर्स मौजूद हैं उनको हम फिल्म्स दिखाएं फिल्म के ज़रिए उनको पॉलिटिकली चीज़ों के बारे में अवेयर करें अपना मतलब हिस्टोरिकल मूवमेंट्स को जाने तो उसी के चलते हमने डेली स्क्रीनिंग शुरू की है ट्रॉली टॉकीज के नाम पर
26 जनवरी को लेकर क्या खास तैयारियां हैं
26 जनवरी को लेकर जैसे ट्रॉली टॉकीज क्या भाई आर्ट के थ्रू आप रेसिस्टेंस को एक्सप्रेस करते हो तो हम देख रहे हैं कि 26 तारीख को लेकर एक यहां पर टेबलो बना रहे हैं जिसमें जो एग्रेरियन क्राइसिस है फार्मर इश्यू और उसके साथ में जो गवर्नमेंट का जो एक एपैथी है पूरे इस आंदोलन के खिलाफ उसको लेकर हम कुछ आर्ट के थ्रू एक्सप्रेस करना चाहते
हैं आप कितने उत्साहित हैं इससे काम करने के लिए और क्या खास कर रहे हैं
इसमें हम ये दिखाना चाहते हैं कि जैसे किसान जो हैं जो हम लोगों को हर तरीके का खाने को और हमारे देश की अर्थव्यवस्था को जो चलाता है उसकी जो आर्थिक दुर्दशा है उसको हम देखते हैं कि किस तरीके से ये मोदी सरकार जो है किस तरीके से बर्बाद करने पे टिकी हुई है उसी के लिए हमने ये रात से हम लोग लगे हुए हैं कि एक किसान की भूमिका क्या होती है और जो 26 तारीख को परेड है उसमें हम अपना किसान खड़ा कर रहे हैं
ओके तो आप खास या बहुत सारी चीज़ें रिसाइकल भी यूज़ कर रहे हैं
हाँ वही हमारी पॉलिटिक्स भी है एक्चुअली कि ये जो तीनों बिल हैं ये इकोनॉमिकली भी ख़त्म करेगा हमको सोशली भी ख़त्म करेगा और पर्यावरण के लेवल पर भी जो है बहुत क्षति पहुंचाएगा लाइक यू नो हज़ार एकड़ पे भयंकर लेवल पे जो है कि यू नो जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड सीड्स और उस तरीके के हैवी डोज केमिकल्स या फर्टिलाइजर्स जो चलने वाले हैं वो कितना तकलीफ पहुँचाएगा उसलिए हम लोग इसको पूरा रिसाइकल्ड मीडियम में पूरा इंस्टॉलेशन बना रहे हैं सो दैट आर्टिस्ट जो किसान के साथ है वो अपनी बात इस लेवल पर पहुंचा सके कि 95% लोगों के भूख का निवाले का सवाल है वो बर्बाद ना हो
And for those who say that the farmers protesting are only from Punjab, take a look at these visuals that are from earlier in the day. These are in the evening of thousands of farmers from Nashik under the banner of the All India Kisan Sabha entering Mumbai. After walking through the day, they are now in Mumbai where a big rally is being organized at the Azad Maidan tomorrow.
21 district farmers from 21 districts of Maharashtra they gathered at Nashik yesterday and under the banner of All India Kisan Sabha they started moving towards Mumbai and today in the morning the Kasara Ghat which is a stretch of 7 to 8 kilometers between Nashik and Mumbai that's where they walked the Kasara Ghat just to show their numbers show their the display their strength and just let people know that the farmers of Maharashtra are also standing in support with the farmers who are already protesting on the borders of Delhi for the past 2 months so thousands of them the All India Kisan Sabha says about 10 to 15,000 of farmers have joined them and tomorrow is the big meeting here at Azad Maidan That meeting will be attended by top leaders of Mahavikas government and also is NCP Chief Sharad Pawar is expected to attend that meeting, post which the delegation of farmers is expected to go proceed towards from Azad Maidan towards the Governor House. These farmers who are standing in support of their farmers who are protesting in Delhi, they are saying that even they want these farm laws to be repealed. So that is their demand, and it is not just the farmers, but also the tribals and Adivasis have come here to Mumbai, and there are a large number of women farmers who have also arrived in Mumbai. In fact, a delegation of women farmers are also protesting in Delhi, and a lot of them have come here, and they want to just tell the government that even the farmers from Maharashtra have the same demand as that of the farmers from Punjab and Haryana. So thousands of them coming towards Mumbai, and we saw those dramatic visuals earlier as well, how a sea of farmers started walking towards Mumbai, just reminding us of the 2018 visuals when farmers from Nashik came to Mumbai all the way walking from Nashik.
And Congress leader Rahul Gandhi continues his Tamil Nadu campaign for the second day in Western Tamil Nadu, an AIADMK stronghold. On Saturday, campaigning in Coimbatore, Rahul Gandhi took on the ruling AIADMK and its ally, the BJP, and targeted Prime Minister Modi on issues of Tamil pride, culture and agriculture. Today, he campaigned in the Erode and the Tirupur districts and interacted with weavers and addressed a public meeting as well. The DMK Congress Alliance really missed the bus in the 2016 polls as the Congress had contested in 41 seats, just won 8. However, the same alliance swept the Lok Sabha polls in 2019, and this is going to be the first state elections after those two icons, Jayalalitha and Karunanidhi, passed away.
The man with the 56-inch chest.
56-inch marudaiya indha manidhar.
The Prime Minister,
the நாட்டினுடைய பிரதமர்,
is standing silently.
அமைதியாக உட்கார்ந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்.
When Chinese army has occupied our country for the last 3 months, Narendra Modi has not said the word China. It has not come out of his mouth. The Chinese understand that the man running this country is weak. The Chinese understand that the Prime Minister of India has destroyed the economy of India.
And on a two-day visit to the Northeast, Union Home Minister Amit Shah today was in Lower Assam for twin rallies, first at Kokrajhar to be part of the first anniversary of the Borderland Accord with the NDFP, the second in Nalbari, where he launched his party's campaign for the ensuing Assam polls. He promised an infiltration-free Assam, but followed Prime Minister Modi's footsteps by remaining silent on the contentious issues of CAA and the NRC, which are central to Assam's politics on illegal infiltration.
Mitro, main aaj aapko batane aaya ki abhi abhi wahan panchayat ke chunav hue, police ko pure Jammu Kashmir mein ek bhi goli nahi chalai nahi padi aur shanti purvak ye hua. Yahan par bhi chunav hua. 80% से ज्यादा वोटिंग हुआ, जिसने जिसको वोट देना था उसको वोट दिया, मगर कहीं पर भी हिंसा नहीं हुई. एनडीए में यूपीपीएल का आना और यहां यूपीपीएल बीजेपी की साझा सरकार बनना, वो बताती है कि आने वाले दिनों में पूर्ण बहुमत के साथ भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार आसाम के अंदर बनने वाली है. ये इसका ट्रेलर है. ट्रेलर मैं पूछना चाहता हूं कांग्रेस पार्टी को, इतने सालों तक असम रक्त रंजित रहा, ये मेरा बोडो क्षेत्र रक्त रंजित रहा, क्या किया आपने? बदरुद्दीन अजमल की जोड़ी सारे दरवाजे खोल देगी और घुसपैठ को असम के अंदर सरल करके दी, क्योंकि उनकी वोट बैंक है. वोट बैंक घुसपैठ को अगर कोई रोक सकता है तो केवल और केवल भारतीय जनता पार्टी की नरेंद्र मोदी सरकार रोक सकती है. एक और 5 साल भारतीय जनता पार्टी को दे दीजिए, हम आसाम को गोली मुक्त कराएं, आसाम को
आंदोलन मुक्त कराए हैं, हम आसाम को बाढ़ मुक्त भी कराने का काम ये भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार।
And nearly 16 lakh Indians have been vaccinated since the 16th of January when the mass inoculation drive against COVID-19 was launched, with 10 lakh Indians taking vaccine shots in just 6 days, a count which is higher than that of countries like the US and the UK, the health ministry says today. The UK took 18 days, while the US took 10 days to reach the 10 lakh mark, the government said. 15.82 lakh people have been vaccinated in 27,000 sessions so far, of which 1.9 lakh people were vaccinated on Saturday alone, according to the health ministry. And some international news right now. Nepal's ruling Minister KP Sharma Oli was removed from the ruling Nepali Communist Party after a central committee meeting of the party's splinter group on Sunday. This is according to the news agency ANI. The now caretaker Prime Minister had decided to dissolve parliament on the 20th of December last year, calling for fresh elections for April and May this year. We're going to go in for a short break. There's more coming up. Welcome back. Some quick sports news. The much-felicitated cricketer Natarajan has shared his experience about facing his first ball by an Australian fast bowler.
மக்கள்லாம் எனக்கு எல்லாமே சப்போர்ட் பண்ணது எல்லாமே அவங்க தான். நான் வந்தது காரணம் எல்லாமே மக்களுக்கு தெரியும். கடின உழைப்பு மட்டும்தான் நான் இப்போ சொல்கிறேன். நல்லா ஹார்ட் ஒர்க் பண்ணால் கிடைக்காம விஷயமே இல்லை. மூணு நாள் கழிச்சு நான் பேட்டிங் ஆடணும். அதான் நான் ஃபஸ்ட் அந்த இன்டர்வியூவில் ஏதோ எங்கள் பிசி இன்டர்வியூவில் சொல்லியிருந்தேன். ஃபஸ்ட் பால் எனக்கு கண்ணுக்கு தெரியல தெரியல. எனக்கு அது ரொம்ப லைஃப்லேயே அந்த மாதிரி ஸ்பீடை இப்போ தான் ஃபஸ்ட் டைம் ஆடுறோம். ஆமாம், அது ரொம்ப நல்ல எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸாக இருந்தது. முக்கியமான காரணம் நான் அங்க வந்து பிராக்டிஸ் பண்ணது, கோச்சஸ்க்கு நிறைய தெரியும் நான் எப்படி என்னோட ஸ்ட்ரென்த் என்ன, என்னோட இது அவங்களுக்கு தெரிஞ்சிருக்கும். அதனால என்ன எல்லா ஃபார்மேட்லயும் ஆட வச்சிருப்பாங்க. பிளஸ் எனக்கு மெயின் பிளஸ் என்னன்னா லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட்ற ஒரு அட்வான்டேஜ்.
And some tech news. Even though the Consumer Electronics Show was digital this year, the show witnessed interesting technology launches and announcements. And here's a look at some of the best products showcased at the biggest tech show in the world in the lifestyle genre.
Originally introduced at CES 2020, Samsung Terrace made a cameo in this year's CES as well. Samsung claims that this year's Terrace TV will not only come with QLED panel, but will also have increased durability. The TV is IP55 rated and is durable against water and dust. With the menace of air pollution getting lethal every year, buying an air purifier has become a necessity. LG took this concern into consideration when the brand introduced its latest lineup of air purifiers under its PuriCare range. The virtual conference showed a montage of a wearable air purifying mask. LG did not reveal the specs behind this mask at the press conference, but this innovation sure grabbed a lot of eyeballs. $16,000. Yes, that's the price of taking a bath in Kohler's latest still bathtub. This ultra-luxurious bathtub comes complete with grates on the floor that can provide the user infinity overflow. The bathtub is inspired by Japanese spas and emulate the same experience that a conventional spa would provide a user. Thankfully, Kohler has announced that this high-tech bathtub will be available in 4 variants, with the lowest spec one starting at just $6,000. Yeah, even we are surprised we used just here. Kohler has its sights set this year on changing the way we use our washrooms. This intention becomes crystal clear with its latest touchless faucet. Not only can you command this faucet to disperse water using gestures, but you can also talk to it. And how? One word, Alexa. Yes, this faucet is Alexa enabled.
And finally, Genshin Impact is the latest game that's topping all of the charts. What is it about this open-world fantasy-based game that's amassing a huge user base? Find out in our review.
Genshin Impact is topping gaming charts everywhere. But what is it about this cross-platform RPG that makes it so popular? Here's what you need to know. At its core, Genshin Impact is an open-world RPG with some of the best graphics that mobile games have ever seen. Developed by Chinese publishers miHoYo, the game is set in a fantasy world called Teyvat. You can explore this vast, expansive land by choosing one character out of a massive list of 23 playable ones and set sail to your adventures. While you can do tasks and level up your characters, the real fun is away from the storyline and in moving around, exploring this vast fantasy world. You can engage in fights with gods and monsters and fine-tune your combat skills. Speaking about combat, there is something for everyone here with melee, ranged and magic, and each character has their own special abilities that you can master.
So here's what I like the most about Genshin Impact. You don't necessarily have to go around doing all these tasks that the game has set out for you. Instead, you can just explore and marvel and relish the beauty of these unparalleled mobile game graphics that the game has for you. But here's where the game falls flat. The storyline. It's not the most pacey one out there, and the developers have used a lot of cliches in the book. Instead, you can just travel on the road not taken and explore the in-game world and earn some in-game currency to develop your characters.
Overall, Genshin Impact is a great game to spend time with. It is a freemium game, meaning you can play it for free, but there are certain in-app purchases to give you a boost and enhance your overall experience. Where this game takes the cake is its well-designed interactions and the surreal graphics that will give you a sense of adventure while playing it.